Good morning, students. Today we will start the new topic, graphical representation of motion. We will now discuss the various type of graph which can be used to calculate speed or velocity, acceleration and distance traveled by a body. A very important point to remember here is that in drawing of graph, the terms speed, velocity are used in the same sense. Okay, so we will first study the distance time graph and speed time graph, or we can say velocity time graph. Please, very important point to note that in drawing graph based on motion, time is always along the x-axis, and distance or speed we can take on the along the y-axis. Okay, so today first we have to define distance time graph. In distance time graph, when a body moves, first we have to draw the graph. Time we have to take on x-axis, and on y-axis we have to take a distance. Right, when a body moves with uniform speed, it will travel. Uniform speeds means it will travel equal distance in equal interval of time. Okay, so for uniform speed, the graph distance travels against time will be straight line. It should be straight line. As time increases, distance increases at equal interval of time. So this straight line graph expresses the point that is uniform speed. The distance time graph of body moving at uniform speed is always a straight line. It is always a straight line. And now we have to calculate the speed from, how we can calculate the speed from distance time graph. As you know, distance upon time is speed. So from the graph only, we can calculate the distance, and we can calculate the distance first and time. Then we can find out the speed. Speed is equal to distance travel upon time taken. So from the graph, how we can find out this graph, the slope. First we have to take the slope of distance time graph, indicate the speed of the body. This is the slope, so it will indicate the speed of the body. To find the speed from distance time graph of a body, we have to take one point. We are taking this point as A, and we have to draw one parallel line parallel to time axis and one parallel line to the y axis. So we are getting one point C here and B on the x axis. Okay. So simply we have to find out the speed. Speed is distance travel upon time taken. What is the distance travel? Distance represented by AB. This is the distance. And AB, and time is OB. Okay. This point is O. This point is O. So easily, if we know the value of AB or CO, because both are parallel, AB is parallel to CO. So distance travel is AB upon OB. So easily we can find the speed from the graph. Now the second point is, we have to draw the graph for non-uniform motion. Okay, in non-uniform motion, we are taking the time on x-axis, and on y-axis we are taking the distance. As you have seen in the figure, this is not a straight line graph. Here the graph is a parabola. Okay, the motion is accelerated, so that as the time increases, there is a little distances increase. As the distance increase more, but time is increase less. So this is a non-uniform motion. The speed of a body is non-uniform, then the graph between distance traveled and time is curved line, called a parabola. We know that when a body moves with a non-uniform motion, that is said to be non-uniform speed. Then the motion is said to be accelerated. The motion of an object is get accelerated, so it will change. It will increase the speed of the body. So the curved line OA represents the non-uniform speed. From this figure also we can represent the line. Start here. in the previous video we have seen that a body, the speed of a body is uniform. Okay, that speed of a body is uniform, then its distance time graph is a straight line, right? Now in this figure, time we are taking on x-axis and on y-axis we are taking the distance on y-axis. So the graph is in a slope form, it is a parabola, okay, because the motion of an object is accelerated. Accelerated means the velocity become increase and increase and increase, distance increase, time also, distance is increase as a time, okay. So that is known as a non-uniform motion. And the curve which represented by OA, it represent the non-uniform speed, because you know speed is what? Speed is distance upon time. So in this case, speed distance is more as comparatively to the time. So speed is accelerated and the slope is in the form of a parabola. Thank you. Now the second point we have to discuss, velocity time graph or speed time graph. We have three type of speed time graph for a moving body. First is when speed of a body remain constant. Speed of a body remain constant means when there is a no acceleration. Second, when speed of a body changes at a uniform rate. Third, when a speed of a body changes at non-uniform way. Okay, first we have to define first part, that is when speed of a body remain constant. Okay, first we have to draw the graph between speed and time. Because there is a, when a speed of a body remain constant, when a speed of a body remain constant, it is parallel to the x-axis. This is x-axis and this one is y-axis. Already we have done in the previous graph that time always we have to take on the y-axis, and on the other side we will take speed or distance. So in this case we are taking speed on y-axis and time on x-axis. Okay. The speed of a body is constant. This means that the speed does not change with time. Here, this is constant. This is parallel to the time. So, there is a no change with time. Here, if there is a no change with time, it means there is no acceleration. So, speed time graph of a body moving with a constant speed. So, it is moving with a constant speed. So, from this, easily we can calculate the distance. How much distance is there? Speed, as we know, speed is equal to distance travel upon time taken. From this graph, we can calculate distance equal to cross multiply speed into time. So then what is the speed? Here, from this graph, we can put the value of the speed. BC. BC is the speed, but BC is parallel to OA. So we can put it here, speed is OA. And what is the time? OC is parallel to AB. So OC we can take as time here. So this is, if we are taking this OBC and OC, so then this is equal to the area of a rectangle OABC. This, it form a rectangle OABC. So easily we can find out the distance by using this graph, speed and time. We can calculate the distance. Thank you. Now we have to start the second part, that speed time graph. Speed time graph when speed changes at uniform rate. Okay, so first we have to draw when a body moves with the uniform rate. Uniform rate means with uniform acceleration. Its speed changes by equal amount in equal interval of time. So simple, we have to draw the graph between speed and time. That is uniform rate. So it will move in a straight line. Okay, so this is a uniform . So from the graph easily we can find out the uniform acceleration. Okay, how we can find out? Here we have to point out, this is point O, and we have to draw one parallel line to the speed. We are taking as Q, this is sorry, this is P and then this is R, right? So now from the graph, how we can calculate the acceleration? Acceleration is change in speed. Change in speed upon time. Okay, from the graph, what is the change in speed? Change in speed is PQ. PQ is the change in speed. And time taken is OQ. So by putting the value, this PQ upon OQ, it will give the acceleration from the graph. If we know the values, easily we can put the value of PQ divided by OQ and then we can find out the acceleration of the body. Then the second one, we have to find out the uniform retardation. So in the retardation, what, how we can draw the diagram? Retardation is like that. Okay, the body is retarding. So time on x-axis and speed on y-axis. Okay, speed on y-axis. Now we have to calculate the retardation from this graph. This is point O, this is point A, this is point B. Now we have to find out the retardation. So easily we can find out from the retardation part, the distance traveled by a moving body in a given time is also, we can calculate by speed time graph. And as we explained earlier, the distance traveled by the body in time inter corresponding to point from the speed time graph of a body, a straight line sloping upward. This is a graph which is sloping upward direction. Shows uniform acceleration. On the other hand, in speed time graph of a body, straight line sloping down. When it is down, this is uniform retardation. When from a body starting from A and it will move sloping down from A to B, that is known as a uniform retardation. It should be noted that we can also use the word velocity in place of a speed everywhere in the above discussion. If we are writing here speed, we can write it here velocity also. Okay, because speed is distance upon time and displacement is also known as a velocity is known as a displacement upon time. So wherever we are using speed, we can use velocity also. Thank you. Now we have to discuss the third part for the non-uniform. Third part we will discuss for non-uniform, speed time graph for non-uniform. Third is speed time graph for non-uniform motion. Okay, so in this case, we have to draw a diagram between same speed and time. Okay, and this is a non-uniform. So it means the body changes in an irregular manner. The body changes in irregular manner like this. So the speed time graph of a body is a zigzag motion. Even now the distance traveled by a body is given by area between speed time graph and time axis.